Hey, what's up, everybody? It's David Nichols. I am CEO of Loop, and I'm here today to talk to you about a very cool new toy that I have for just a very short time. Here it is. It is called a Zivid Two. Let's check it out. Take a close look. What big eyes you have. Hold on. We need to talk right away about how this thing works. It's not actually two eyes, because one of these, and I'm pretty sure it's this one, is actually not an eye. It is a projector. And that's because the job of this camera is to create a point cloud of 3D dots. And the way that it does that is that it shoots out a pattern. That pattern is called a structured light pattern. It shoots that grid, that pattern, onto static field of objects. And then it watches very carefully with what happens with this eye over here. The way that that pattern distorts, you can calculate backwards to figure out exactly how far away could that distortion have occurred. And because of the offsets here, because of the baseline, it's able to reestablish a depth field from that camera. And then what do you know? It's an RGB point cloud. The reason we're so interested in this technology is because robots and equipment and a lot of manufacturing technologies is going from being this like blind and completely repetitive process to being really highly dynamic. When you can see with 3D cameras, when you can see with vision, when you can add a lot of this extra information into the process, there are a lot of interesting new things that machines can be capable of, whether that's grabbing, manipulating, avoiding and tracking, or even just dealing with really highly dynamic scenes. A couple of quick notes. One thing that's nice about this camera is it's a proper industrial camera. It's got an IP65 rating, so go ahead and splash some water on it. Don't shoot it into your eyes. I may have already violated that one. Sorry to my eyes. And you can see here, it just has two plugs on the back. This is a power plug and this is an Ethernet plug. And you put these two in and you run it back and off you go. Cloud of points. And not just any cloud of points, but look at this. I'm looking at individual Lego dimples from like a meter and a half away. Here's my 120-sided die. See, it's picking up the edge of that. I've got a loop axis helper here. It's picking up that RGB. It's picking up beautifully the surface of my workbench. And this point cloud density is really, really tight. I think this is maybe an 18 or 20 millimeter hole, and it's just getting every little piece of it. This Lego Lunar Lander I've got here, you can see the Lego dimples on it. This camera is an absolute beast because I did very little, and that was only about a half second of capture time. If I crank it up to 10 seconds, it'll be a lot easier to see the light patterns that it's doing, and it'll have a slightly tighter, more accurate image. But honestly, as I've been fiddling with this, I haven't really noticed really that much of a difference at all, even with longer capture time. So I've got this set of vice grips, and I can see even little dimples on there. It's doing really well. It's not really struggling with that at all. I can see the depth and the shape of that and the color map to it really nicely.
Dominic, do you want to see something cool?
No, I hate cool things.
Watch this.
Wow.
It's cool looking. Isn't
that cool? Okay, what is the box of color?
It's a box
of crayons.
Literally a box of color.
That's what I have on hand.
Naturally.
If this is interesting to you, hit us up and let's talk about a new machine concept sometime soon. Thanks a lot. See you next time.